So the song is called Living in a Box by the band named Living in a Box, and I believe the album was also called Living in a Box. You're welcome. Well, if you think a recession is coming, you might be, you know, living in a box. Eric Chemie is here now to explain why cardboard boxes may be this year's big thing.
Technically corrugated, we'll get
corrugated.
Into it. Yeah. Investors have gotten skittish in the last few weeks. That's not a surprise about the strength of the economy. But one unusual economic data point suggests things are fine, and that's how many boxes are being made and shipped across the country. In the past, a downturn in those numbers has been indicative of a recession coming. Traders and economists, even Alan Greenspan, would study box data to get macro insights. The idea is that an increase in box shipments is correlated to consumer demand and industrial production. More boxes should mean more commerce. The most recent data from the Fiber Box Association, Brian, shows the trend in box shipments still increasing across the country. But this simple indicator may not be as predictive this time around, as the nature of commerce and manufacturing has changed over the past two decades. Despite the rise of online shopping, for example, box shipments are much lower now than they were 20 years ago. Mark Sutton, the CEO of International Paper, has said that box demand no longer has a direct correlation to U.S. GDP, but the Fiber Box Association says box shipments are still a valid economic indicator and is correlated with industrial production. That's why traders, they're looking at boxes to get any edge they can, Brian.
It's amazing, too. I'm sure you order stuff on Amazon. You've got a new baby at home. Do you ever get how many boxes they use?
They do a box inside
of a box. And it's like if you order boxes, do the boxes come in a box?
Sometimes. But here's what's interesting. The way they measure it, first of all, corrugated is what it is. It's the smooth layer.
What does that mean?
It's the smooth layer with a smooth layer, and then they got that ridgy thing in between.
Like the air pocket.
That thicker box.
I assume that was meant as some sort of a buffer in case the box.
Whereas regular cardboard, technically, is like a postcard or a cereal box or a toothpaste box. So it's not that they're counting. And what they're doing is they're measuring it on billions of square footage of the box flattened out. So a lot of smaller boxes, they're not the same as a giant box. If you flatten it out, you don't have that much material there. So that's the data that they're tracking. And so far, it's been going up and up and up over this entire economic run of, let's say, the last 7, 8, 9 years.
I like it. It's a cool new indicator. And we learned why it's called a corrugated box.
Corrugated box.
Every
day.
It's
that triple layer.
So win. Just so many wins. It's just winning.
A lot of stuff I thought was cardboard was technically corrugated. It's just so thin, but that little ridgy layer is inside there.
Yeah, I like it. The corrugation, I guess, is what you call it. Eric Chemie, good stuff.
You got it,
Brian.